was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long. Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
All right, guys, what do you think? Mind control or escape? Mind control or escape? I was supposed to be doing viewer's choice for these, and I kind of let that slide a little bit. What do you want to see? Mind control or escape? Let's give it 30 seconds for the chat to catch up. Whoa, I keep hitting my pop guard. It's one for mind control. One for escape. Two for escape. Looks like we're going for escape, guys. Let's do this.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Violent death? Not like the sound of that.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death. Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise. He reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man. So he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life. Farewell, Stanley.
Farewell, Stanley.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly. And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley...
It's alright, Zena, I've played through all this before. In his office, as alive We're as trying alive. To get as many endings
what
as possible.
What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish? When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
It's a good ending, this one. Ooh, solitaire. Yeah, we're about 1 hour 44 minutes into the stream now. If you wanna, I am gonna be uploading this to YouTube though, so if anyone missed the beginning, it will be there in the next couple of days. I don't have space engineers, unfortunately, not yet anyway. Double click the blue button with the rocket. Where? Which blue button with the rocket? Alright, you're talking about some weird stuff. I'm sure there's another. I'm sure there's a couple of endings in here. It's been a while since I played through all of this. My favourite game. It's a bit too hard to answer that. I've got many, many different favourite games. Zomboid is one of them. Certainly my favourite zombie game. I can't believe like 20 minutes on you're still fapping in the chat. Ah, you guys are nuts.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free. Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now and it'll be your only true choice. Whatever you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let time...
Not too late, Xenomorph. No, we've been streaming nearly 2 hours now. We've done a few endings already. But like I say, I will be uploading all this to YouTube, so you will be able to see it again soon if you want. Wait a minute, I thought we had an end there. There should be a link to my YouTube channel underneath the video for anyone who is not subscribed already.
Stanley was alone. Finally.
Shameless plug.
This is great, he thought to himself. This is what I've wanted all along. I got what I wanted. No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
There we go. What's going on? Why didn't... that's an odd one.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Right, we'll go for mind control next, I think.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Thank you for the link, Jamie.
Of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's.
Oh, I'm glad
office,
you bought the game from my videos. It's always nice to hear.
Stanley walked upstairs to
glad you enjoy him, Lawrence. Who's fighting in the chat? Oh, they're not being serious. Money for breakfast. Money crisp. Extreme bathrooms. Yeah, I'll do that one at some point, Lunas. I have played through this before quite a few times. Yeah, why haven't you got your sword? There we go. Well, all right. Yeah, talking of beer, let me have some of mine. Let's listen to some awesome elevator music. Do, 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 do. Stanley. Alright, it's enough of that. No, I'm not going to do the 4-hour baby button ending. We already did, we got to the baby, and we're not going to do that one.
Stepping into his manager's office,
I got the beer ages ago, Jammy Boy.
Stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean? Stanley wondered aloud to nobody. He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf, looking behind paintings, desperate for clues to his situation. But his attention was.
Oh, you're on the whiskey. I might have to break out the Southern Comfort desk. Later.
What could its purpose be? In fact,
I got the beer ages ago, Jammy. I can't believe you missed that.
Lay buried below his feet. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Stanley simply began entering random codes.
Yeah, we've already done this one.
Knowing full well the sheer statistical unlikelihood that this... Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Ah, right. I've been drinking it all the way through this stream! Ah, as if you've not seen that. Look at that, we're almost finished. I'm gonna have to go get another one. Actually, I think that's my last brown ale. I might have some black sheep in the cupboard somewhere.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Alright, we'll go Mind Control.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
I'm not sure how long this stream's going to go, Saturnator. We've been going nearly 2 hours now, trying to get as many endings as we can. But I can't tell you exactly when I'll end it. Just whenever, I guess.
Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of
but welcome
so
to the stream, buddy.
Reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Oh, I'm trying to remember how we get the disco end, and I think we've got to run back across the bridge or something.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible
to
believe.
Hello, Al Rosenfield.
True. Had Stanley really been
welcome
under
to the stream.
Control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Oh, I remember, don't we? Oh,
no,
yeah, I've got to get back out of there before it goes, that's
it.
Right.
He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never! It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Do I run ads? Yes, I do. Not on Twitch. On YouTube.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
Off or on? I'll let you guys decide. What do you think? Thank you for the links, Jamie Sauce. Yeah, I've got a YouTube channel you can subscribe to if you want. I do daily videos, 2 or 3 videos a day. This entire stream will be getting uploaded to YouTube. As long as I don't get any technical issues. Please don't cut this out, Eki. What am I going to cut out? Oh, the chat. Nah, it's alright. That's why the chat's up on the screen. Well, you just click skip Xenomorph. That's 1 for on, 3 for off. That's 4 for off. We're going off. We'll come back and do on afterwards. Welcome to the stream, all the new people. Costili, Satuna, who else have I missed? Welcome all, anyway.
Chill of uncertainty. Was it over? Yes. He had won. He had defeated the machine. Unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away. And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved. Where had his co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp? What other mysteries did this strange building hold? But as sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him, for it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his. And that was all he needed to know.
The Twitch chat, I'm not sure why it's going slow.
The only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door.
Yeah, it's just Twitch. Freedom!
Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin. The feeling of liberation, the immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.
Yay.
A soft wind blew outside and perhaps rain started, and if it did, it stopped shortly after. Stanley hoped that he would one day see weather.
We just saw weather. Alright, so we're going back and we're going to do... What did we just do? Off? We'll do on next.
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door on his left.
You always end up back here, Jammy Boy. That's the thing with this game.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office.
No more broom closet.
An answer there. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.